Hello guys, and welcome back to an AWF F1 Cards Kent stream. Here we are for GP3, round 12, around the Italian Grand Prix. I'm your commentator, and only steward for today, because everyone hates me. And no one's to steward with me, because I'm lonely. Anyway, onto the action. As Busquets in the Red Bull goes down towards turn 1, on his flying lap bit wide on the apex, affects his run down towards the second chicane. On the prime tyres, remember, so you have the best grip out of the corners. And sets a 20 dead first sector, but fairly clean through there, one of the most hated corners from the drivers. Go through Lesmo 1. Bit wide through Lesmo 2, bit squirmy on exit as well, but so far it's been a you could say an average lap from Busquets, not setting the world alight, and he knows that as well. Just probably a banker lap for Bus. Good line through though. Oh, a bit wide through the second part of Ascari, down towards the famous Parabolica. Right, just before the 50 metre board, gets a bit wider than exit, affects his power throughout the corner, and sets a lap for 22.6. Currently takes provisional pole, and let's see. He's on a good lap, we believe, and has to pull off into the pit lane. Let's watch Huge Bob. Small situation for the Mercedes. Down towards Parabolica. It's a good line through there. Managed to carry the speed. Could have carried that bit more speed, got on the power earlier, but it's a good lap from Bob, is it? Goes fourth. Not the best lap from Bob. Maj Dope goes fastest on a 21.1. Magnussen starting his lap. Gone, just. There we go. Right. It's a tiny set off the. Sorry. The loads, you could say. Good line from Magnussen. 27.7 first sector. Could have avoided the grass there. Affected his speed down towards Lesmo 2. Oh, and he's lost it on the entry. To the grass that could have affected his run. Can't be forward to doing that in the race. No, Schumacher is not on a lap after getting second fastest. A grid so far. Schumacher only goes a tenth behind after setting a very, very good first sector compared to the likes of Maj Dope. Then look at the middle sector from Maj, a class apart from the rest of the field. A 27.1, and then a slight bit faster in the last sector. Probably his run through Ascari. Is old Manzi on a lap? He could well be on a lap. Yes, I think he is. And he sets the first set over 28.1. Oh, ruined it through the chicane. Got too wide an entry. That should affect his line through the rest. We'll stay on board with him though, because it was a personal best through the sector that's better through Ascari. The Lesmo 2. Oh, and that's going to be abandoned. Surely. 28.8 though, which is a par with his best as well. So it's Not improving by much. Let's see through the final. Oh, you can't carry the speed through. And looks like, yeah, he's peeling off into the pit lane. Let's go watch the driver, shall we? It's brutal, was on an outlap, as is Gutierrez, as is Buzzkid. Only three drivers on track right now. As Gutierrez now starts his lap. Good line from Gutierrez as he starts his lap. Five first sets, a good first set, a good line through the chicane as well. Good line, Gutierrez. Takes good amount of speed through there. It's a good line. Coming towards Ascari, it's a good line. If he can. Oh! If he hadn't gone wide there, that would have been a very, very good line to Ascari. And sets a 21.7, which is a good lap on primes. Buzzkid on a lap. Let's go. Who else was on the lap? It was Brutal, who goes now third. He goes a thousandth quicker than Gutierrez. Buzzkid now on the lap. It's going on exit, but it won't affect his run that much. And now sets a 27.6, which I believe is a very good sector. Yes, it is. Let's see. Buzzkid, 14th pole position. Goes 4/10 faster than Mazda. Very, very good at that. Purple last sector. Though, I'm see what he can do. Two viewers going watch. Oh, that's nice from Schumacher. Could have taken a bit more speed on exit though, using all the fags ahead from the car. Ghosted, that would be Bob in the McLaren. Nice line. Turn on. Yeah. Oh, that's an exit, but cost him time, then he'll gain it. It's another good line through there. 27.4, which is pole time. Middle set to. Oh, it gets wide. He's. Gutierrez is going to come back out. Schumacher's not on a lap. Busquets not on a lap. Magnussen possibly about to start a lap. They're on board. Out for another run. I think that's his third run on option tyres. Oh, well, here's a lap. Old Man Z 31. Bit messy. Good light corner though, that's better from Old Manzi. This did propel him, I think, up the grid. No, it doesn't. But does improve. No, 23. Line from Gutierrez. It's better from him. Down towards the chicane. 27.3, good first sector. Now if that was clean, that was very, very good through that sector. Or that part of the track. Down to fourth. Through Lesmo 1. Good speed carried. Not as wide as Schumacher. It's also good speed through Lesmo 2. Not as wide as Magnussen, otherwise that would have forced him into the gravel, just like Magnussen on his first run. Let's see, this should be a very good middle sector. So 27.1, oh, that's very nice for Gutierrez. This looks to be a stellar lap from him, the Mexican. Bit wide through the final corner. That cost him some exit speed. Couldn't get the powers early. But this should be a good time. It's a 19.8. It's a great lap from Gutierrez. Great speed. Here's Brutal. On a lap. Oh. Took a bit too much of the inside curb. Couldn't carry the speed. 2.00 doesn't improve on his 21.7. If anyone else is on a lap, could be on another lap. Let's see. Yes, I believe he will be. Old Manzi's not on a lap. Gutierrez had to set in his lap. Schumacher's coming out again on the options, possibly to see if he can sneak pole. But let's watch Brutal for now. 28.1 first sector, which quickly check. He doesn't improve on. I'd just back off now. Safety is set for the race. Could be possibly needed if for the likes of the safety car. Yeah, and he's backed off. He knows. But now the only guy that could improve. Oh, Magnussen is coming out again. So you got the two Mercedes, 6th and 7th on the grid. Schumacher's that could challenge for pole. Don't get me wrong, 1.1 seconds off the pace. He's improving that in the last two sectors. His foot sector is very, very good from Schumacher. That time's actually quicker than GP1 qual, which was set by me. Not to brag or anything. But it was a conservative lap time by myself. As Brutal enters the pit lane, Gutierrez will shortly follow. Schumacher rallied by the home faithful, the Tifosi. Can he get a win right here? put him as a good favourite of mine, along with Gutierrez, a possible huge Bob, depending on instance, and obviously their race time. Oh, their race pace. But here we go, WF1 Schumacher starts his lap with 35 seconds remaining on the time. Let's see, can he get the brake? He needs to brake late, but get that car turning to the right and to the left. Nice from Schumacher, he's the speed. 27.3 was the fastest first sector from Gutierrez. But no, Schumacher already sent a 27.4 on primes. This should be an improvement, possibly. It is a 27.2, the fastest so far. Now, it didn't take as much speed through there as Gutierrez, but it was still a very, very good... very good corner. Takes that with good speed as well. Opens the DRS. That's what from the broadcast view. As he approaches Ascari with good speed and confidence. This is good luck from Schumacher. As you can see, he's 2 tenths up time, I believe. That could be on his time all through that sector. I expect this to be either second or pole. Second on the grid, Magnussen also just coasting along. Let's see what Schumacher actually set. He set a 20.3, which was half a second off pole, but beat Bob's 20.6 quite comfortably in the end. Is anyone starting those prime tyres? If Buzz is in a good position. As Magnussen hits the gravel, despite it being removed from the Parabolica. As he crosses the line. And there, guys, is your grid. Gutierrez on pole with a 19.8, followed by Schumacher 4 tenths behind on a 20.3. Huge Bob runs out the top three in the McLaren Honda on a 20.6. Managed with a 21.1. Busking on the prime tyres, by the way, in fifth. Magnussen and Brutal in the Mercedes 6 and 7, separated by 7 thousandths of a second. And Almanzi in the Lotus runs off the grid with a 22.4. Actually, can you actually not hit?
You can do the gridwalk again.
Oh no, I'm such a spanner. Right, so if you didn't miss that, guys, Shane wants a win. Buzzkid wants a safety car, and Gutierrez, I had no clue what he said. What a great Italian race in store.
He did a left-right of the chicane. Right-left, even, not left-right. Because otherwise he would have gone to the wall. He would have gone into the wall.
Right, so you just missed all of that. Right, Bob wants us to hurry up. It's the Italian Grand Prix.
It's time.
That grid walk did not work out, but we are looking at our two-stop race here today. Buzzkid wants a safety car, especially with Ensign on those prime tyres. He'll be an interesting one to watch throughout the race. Shane, WF1 Schumacher, was very disappointed with his quality. I feel like he could get a lot more time out of the car, but feels as if he can still challenge for the win. Whereas Gutierrez, very, very good quality, that, a 19.8. It's going to be right. As the guys have read it up, it's the Italian Grand Prix live from WF1 Kart Cairns, your spicy Indians streamer. As we run through the grid, on par we have WF1 Gutierrez, followed by Schumacher and Bob. Let's see what the Italian Grand Prix has in store. And Schumacher is already alongside Gutierrez and takes the lead into the first corner. Gutierrez goes back up his inside, but the traction out the corner should help Schumacher, as you can hear. Well, you can't, but you can imagine what the Tifosi is screaming and shouting as they head down towards turns 3 and 4. As Gutierrez in second, Huge Bob in third, Magnussen's had a great start in fourth, Buzzkid remains in his position of fifth, Maj Doat's been the main loser, Dan is sixth. Oh, as Buzzkid's gone wide, Maj Doat put back up to fifth, Buzz down to sixth, both losing places. Old Manzi 31 in seventh, and a bit brutal's in eighth. So we head back up to the front. Gutierrez starting to put pressure on Schumacher. As he goes down towards Parabolica. Already establishing a bit of lead over Bob. Magnussen looking very, very racy. Close towards Bob. But as we head down towards turn one for the first time, as they cross the line, Schumacher leads for Ferrari, followed by Gutierrez in second. Huge Bob in third, but could be overtaken by Magnussen. Huge Bob going defensive. Magnussen holds back. As I said, Magnussen in fourth. Buzzkid in fifth. So what happens to Maj Doat? Because a bit brutal's now jumped ahead of both the Lotuses. As Oldman Z31 is in seventh, and Maj Doat into eighth from fourth on the grid. A poor start from Maj Doat. As a bit brutal's looking a bit racy. No, decides not to go up the inside. As Magnussen's all over the back of Huge Bob. As we go back towards the front again. Schumacher and Gutierrez go down towards Ascari. Schumacher doing exactly what he needs to do, just delaying Gutierrez. But Gutierrez is up the inside. He got a great run out of Ascari. Schumacher goes round the outside. Great defending job. Yep. It's Gutierrez, it's the fastest off of 22.9. Will he look up the inside? The voice break there. Will he look up the inside of Schumacher? No, he doesn't, but we need to look behind because Magnussen takes a position. Off huge Bob. Great move. Just as we look towards the front two again. Obviously, DRS will now be activated for the first time on this lap. So now in third. Great, good race pace from Magnussen's side already to pull away from the likes of Buzz, who's on those prime tyres. A bit brutal, but coming, I'd say, a bit frustrated so far. Mazdev in 7th and Old Manzi in 8th. We'll go back to the front. Huge Bob is now in 3rd. What's happened? As Magnussen spun again on that corner. He's got quite an advantage and Magnussen getting a bit out of shape. But we'll head now to the leaders again between WF1 Schumacher and WF1 Gutierrez. So they've already established themselves a 2.6 second lead from the last lap. What has Schumacher set a faster lap? So he's extending his advantage ever so slightly over Gutierrez. He's not really that close down towards the chicane. This is obviously a sector that Schumacher's very strong. Ferrari power helping him as he go across the long right hander. Magnussen in 3rd, Bob in 3rd, Magnussen 4th. Busquets has now been overtaken by a bit brutal. As Mostro struggling in 7th, not the best race pace so far from him. Obviously falling behind his teammate at one stage did not help him, but managed to get back up into 7th place. Now Magnussen's now looking at the huge Bob's car. He's got a good slipstream DRS, not the best way to place to overtake on this track. Gets the move done. He goes a bit deep into Ascari. Huge Bob undercuts him. A great move there from Huge Bob. It's now the Mercedes. Dreamlags a bit there. Schumacher's now starting to pull. Schumacher's starting to pull away a bit now on Gutierrez. Schumacher controlling the race, you could say now. Possibly using a bit of edge. Know that. Got rid of that early pressure from Gutierrez. Back a leadership, I believe. Sorry, guys. Takes very extensive line. Third with Magnussen still behind him. As Magnussen hits the gravel, Brutal's going to close on him here, and I think Brutal's going to punish him for that mistake. He'll have more confidence on the brakes. Battle of the Mercedes. Brutal taking a good line through the last corner. Brutal's going to get the slipstream. Let's ride on board from Brutal. Well, not on board, but Brutal's going towards the outside on Magnussen. Oh, it's great race between the two Mercedes. No team orders for those guys. He's now going to get back in the slipstream of Brutal. Or he's not, he's in a... There we go, he's back in the slipstream. He's going to... have a little look. Try and force Brutal into a mistake. Can't get the exit speed, and Brutal keeps fourth position. But now this is where... And Buzz is still keeping ahead of Maj. But this is where Brutal's going to start and catch the guys ahead. 10 seconds he has now between him and the leader, which I still believe is Shane. Controlling this race now, it's front two have kind of gone from the likes of Bob, Brutal. Oh, and Buzz. Is that Magnussen again struggling? It was. Now, Buzz, I feel like he had a legal overtake there, so just allowed Magnussen back through. Now Magnussen gets a bit wide, and Buzz kids as Magnussen pits, as does Maj Dope. Now Buzz will get DRS here, which will obviously benefit him, and I won't be surprised if he starts to close in on Brutal, especially with Brutal's tyres starting to wear out. Apologies. As Gutierrez approaches the chicane. Cuts it a bit slightly. Shane still leads this race. As you can see in the distance there. There's the Williams. Probably the ideal lap that these guys should be pitting. I pit it on this lap. On Sunday. My tyres were shot by then. I'm not the most aggressive driver. Let's see. Let's go down the grid. Gutierrez 1.8 now behind, so he's slowly falling from the clutches of Schumacher. Seems like Gutierrez wore his tyres a bit more in quali. And they both stay out. And look, told you, Buzz Kid has closed the gap. On a bit Brutal. And the A bit Brutal stays out. Obviously, if he can hold Buzz up, that will be beneficial for him later in the race. Obviously, Buzz has still yet to use the option tyres. Buzz still, and a Brutal still has to use those prime tyres. To be honest, do feel quite good around here. They're a good tyre for this track. Just like Spa. Right, huge Bob in fifth. Magnussen in 7th. Oh, and he's side by side with Maj Dope. Now Maj should get the traction. Allowing him to... Oh! And I believe that is a safety car. We have a safety car. Our Buzz Kid is overtaking under safety car. But obviously the message hasn't got there yet. Now, did Gutierrez get ahead of Schumacher? He must have done. Because Gutierrez now leads this... Well, doesn't lead, but Buzz Kid leads the race. And he'll be ecstatic as a safety car. Obviously the collision between Magnussen and Maj Dope. As Gutierrez goes wide. What is Gutierrez doing? And he could lose a position to a huge Bob here. And he has done. Gutierrez with his stupid driving there. Well, I wouldn't say stupid driving, but it's a bit weird. to lose his position to Bart, but now he's got some work to do. As you can see, the safety car is out. Max of pits. Now this has worked perfect for Buzz. And he continues. As does Shane, and what a huge Gutierrez in fourth, under pressure from a bit brutal. Now they both went to the pits on the same time. Gutierrez probably not the confidence on these prime tyres, as now the safety car has now been called. Finally. There's your safety car, I'm an Eagle. Behind Shane. Thank you to the five viewers, a follow would be very much appreciated. It's WF1 Schumacher. Huge problem in third. There's Gutierrez, Brutal, Old Manzi, and Maj Doat. And Maxson has only just crossed the line after his collision with Maj. Looked a racing incident, to be honest. Maj just got the better traction out the corner and Maxson hit the rear of him. As Buzzkid continues, I wonder if there's been a loss of communication here. Yeah, Buzzkid realises he's now at 8 option laps till the end, and I imagine he'll pit this lap. There's Magnussen. What an Ascari. Now will Buzzkid actually get ahead of some of his rivals here? When he pits for those option tyres. What does Buzzkid do? He looks like he's pitting. Has Buzz got a puncture? I don't believe so. But Buzzkid is now in the pit lane. I think Buzz is sensibly allowing some of his drivers back through after possibly not realising it was a safety car. He'll take fourth place, which I think is completely fair. He was ahead of Brutal. But this is important for Busker's race. And I'd say, guys, that we are prepared to go this lap. Eagle is bolting off. As we will run through your order, WF1 Schumacher is in first. Bob is in second. The McLaren Honda. Third is WF1 Gutierrez. Fourth is Busquets on some fresh option tyres in the Red Bull. Fifth is a bit Brutal. Sixth is Old Manzi 31. Seventh is Mosto. Eighth is Magnussen. Oh, and Busquets in the wall! I did not see what happened there. As the safety is a huge pop, takes it and goes into the pit lane. I did not see what happened there. Between Busquets and his option tyres, that is important because Buzz has probably lost his advantage now of having those fresh option tyres compared to the rest of the field. He was so high up as well, he had a great opportunity. But I expect us to keep going at the end of this lap. Maybe. Gutierrez just gets out the pit lane. Will we go at the end of this lap? I would suggest we will. Punch back up a bit more. Come on, another lap. Yeah, we're gonna have to go another lap, guys. But then it's the second sector. Yeah. We'll see. Yeah, no, they're gonna go for another lap because he would have gone by now. Now, what will Shane do? Will he pit for some option tyres? Go option to the end? He does not, but the two Lotuses do. Manage fits a prime snap. Will he take those to the... I won't be surprised if Manage Dope takes these prime tyres to the end of this race. As he just cuts the pit line. And Old Manzi does. But same strategy from the Lotus team. Sorry, same strategy from the Lotus team. Can catch back. Magnussen takes an evasive line. Magistrate's behind now. Maybe it was the wrong way to stay. As now we go onto the pit straight of Brutal, a bit Brutal, he's in the slipstream of the Ferrari of WF1 Schumacher. He's going to go up the inside, a bit Brutal. Oh, gets a bit on the gravel, but still gets the traction out the corner. And Schumacher's now under pressure from Magnussen. Bob's on the grass. Oh, there's been a collision between the Lotus, sorry, the Williams and the Red Bull of Busquin, round two. Magnussen and Schumacher, I'd say a bit too far to make the move from Magnussen. Oh, it's a good line from Schumacher. Took so much more speed through the corner than a bit brutal. And look at the gap he's put on Magnussen. But this looks like another easy pass for the Ferrari and the current championship leader of WF1 Schumacher. Gets the power down nicely. The outside of the track. In the slipstream, DRS activated. Up the of the Mercedes. Brutal. Oh, just keeps it on the track. A bit brutal, got a bit of an exit. WF1 Schumacher is now a defender from Bob on the option. As Gutierrez is moving a bit out of it. It's good focusing. And the slower tyres than Bob. Just see the downforce of Schumacher's car through that corner. I'm saying he just hasn't got that front end grip that the Ferrari has. It's now expected, probably an easy pass from Huge Bob up the inside into Ascari. Magnussen will defend it. And probably defends well, I'd say. Got a huge, a tiny tap, but nothing too drastic. Now, Gutierrez gets a bit wide, going through Parabolica. Magnussen will be in the slipstream. DRS activated on Gutierrez. Sorry, guys. A lone steward, I have to do that. As Schumacher controlling the race. But that is brutal. We gained a Magnussen's pulled away from Gutierrez a bit. Not really showing that true pace as Gutierrez, like he has in quali. There's Huge Bob in the McLaren. Much dope. Who possibly going to the end. Or Manzi 31, who could be also going to the end. It's a bit brutal since the fastest lap. It's closed back up again on Schumacher. And probably in the next three laps we'll see these guys all peel off into the pit lane for a fresh set of option tyres that they have saved throughout the weekend. There's Magnussen in third. Gutierrez in fourth, who I believe is still yet to win the prime tyres unless he run them on he ran them in his second stint. Before he got evaporated by Buzz, or it could have been the other way around, I'm not sure yet. There's Huge Bob. Managed to up 6th, who's gained a bit on Schumacher. Must have been a poor lap from Schumacher. And we can see why, because Brutal has gained another 3 tenths. And another 4 tenths. This is a lot closer. Now, is a bit of fuel saving, or is the tyre wear from WF1 Schumacher as he lost that front end grip. His tyres do look a bit shattered. Let's see the gap now. We'll sweep up. It's back up to 8 tenths now. That looks like 8 tenths. It's Gutierrez sets the fastest lap. 21.8 on the outside of WF1 Magnussen. Great move. Yeah, Magnussen just got on the power early but hit the back of Gutierrez. His own fault. Now, I just want to see quickly. That was a 21.8 from Gutierrez. What was the last lap from Shane? It was a 22.9. Is it a 21.8? Yeah, so it's a second. Gutierrez catching these guys ahead. Oh, well, Shane gets a bit out of shape. I think, as does Brutal. But Gutierrez fine through there. He's Bob, fifth. Still, Mash still sixth. Now, can he make those tyres last to the end of the race? Or will he pit for some option tyres? I think Mash would prefer a safety car right now. Nice for Mash through the middle sector. Oh, sorry, through the Sky chicane. As Brutal continues along with Shane. Shane seems to be pulled out of cap again. Is that Magnussen into the pit lane? It is. Gutierrez 4.8 behind. Magnussen goes in for a set of option tyres. He's 12 seconds behind the leader. 11.2. Catching Huge Bob. A bit brutal. Going through the safety car of Iron Eagle. Yeah, it's, I'd say closing the gap on a bit brutal. He seems to be struggling. That gap has fell between him and Schumacher. I'd say I expect both these in this lap. And I'd say Gutierrez will go for one more lap. Then peel off that lane. Nice timeline. Definitely got a lot more confidence. He's gained 3 tenths in the middle sector on Shane. Who can, but a bit just peel off into the pit lane. Will the undercut come into affection? Gutierrez and a bit brutal. And Mash couldn't take those tyres. Neither could he. Let's see when Magnussen comes out. Stretch out of tyres. Mash coming out the pit lane. It's the Williams of Gutierrez. And he looks safe. Good. He'll get the fresh option grip. Obviously cold tyres. Let's see the gap. Would it be nice to see the gap? Schumacher. Oh. And I imagine he'll peel off into the pits this lap. And he does, the Ferrari in the pit lane. Is a bit brutal, it's 24.5 behind. That's 22 seconds for a pit stop here. Magnussen in the slipstream of Gutierrez. Not really going to take any risks there. But there's the important battle. There's Shane out the pit lane. Brutal's only just crossed the line. There is the Ferrari. It's going to be close. A bit brutal. We'll brake later. Warmer tyres. Shane's just got that in hand. And that is well judged by the Ferrari pit crew as Gutierrez goes wide and Magnussen takes P3. The Mercedes has shown some good race pace. Arm Eagle has retired the safety car as Magnussen allows Gutierrez back through for some reason. Busquets on the primes is Maj and Huge Bob. Good quality performances from these two, third and fourth respectively, but not showing good race pace. I expect to move up inside here from Maj. Let's stay on board with this. Maj on the outside. No, Huge Bob covers that, but goes wide into the corner. Maj don't in the slipstream. You can see the guys up ahead. Maj goes up the inside into the Parabolica. Oh, a bit brutal sets of fast. Who's going up the inside of WF1 Schumacher? A bit brutal takes the lead of the Italian Grand Prix ahead of the Ferrari of WF1 Schumacher, but gets traction on the exit. And it's a great move back up the inside. Gutierrez in third, who's dropped Max completely. Busquets in 5th, Bob did stay ahead of Maj, and then Old Manzi in 8th. Should not have the pace there as Old Manzi in 3rd, sorry in 8th. But guess who's coming back into the equation? WF1 Gutierrez has closed the gap on the lead 2. Shane needs to get a move on now, because Gutierrez is coming, and with fresh option tyres that race could come back into the equation from Gutierrez. Let's have a rundown. There's the top 4. Separated by less than 3.5 seconds, or just over 3.5 seconds, as Schumacher takes in 3rd, Magnussen in 4th, Busquets a bit further behind in 5th, but look at the gap, look at this, this could be an overtake. Huge Bob's in such a better run on the option tyres compared to Busquets. The ding-dong battle here, Bob back in the slipstream. He's up the inside. Great move from Bob. Very confident on the brakes. The Old Manzi in 8th. Schumacher looks to have this one in control now. 3 laps to go. But the battle behind is not over. Bit brutal goes defensive. Gutierrez just sets himself up nicely. He'll get such a better line. He'll get on the power earlier. And this should be an easier overtake. Schumacher sets the fastest line. One dead. Gutierrez on the outside of a bit brutal. Will a bit brutal come back on the inside? No, he doesn't. Now, what can Gutierrez do about the race leader? Magnussen's slowly falling back off now, looks like. Mercedes will be on the podium. Just in 3rd place. But will a bit brutal challenge back Gutierrez? No, he leaves it. Possibly for the DRS straight. Busquets retired from the race. Don't know if that was a terminal damage. Huge Bob in 5th. And now obviously managed to put to 6th. And Old Manzi will finish 7th. Barring any other disqualifications. But it looks like with 2 and a bit laps to go, the only battle is there. Maj Dope's a bit too far behind Bob to really do anything unless he post-battle in the latter stages. Gutierrez slowly dropping off now from Schumacher, who looks to have this race in the bag. Gutierrez and Brutal. Good battle between these two, very clean. Would be said for most of the drives, apart from the obviously the one safe, well, the two safety cars you could call it. One on the restart, and one for a collision between, I believe, Maj and Magnussen, which to be honest looked like a recent from me just looking back. But here's Schumacher, let's give him a bit of time on the cameras. As he enters through Ascari, nicely taken. Through the trees, on the helicopter, board shot. Brakes at the 50 metres board. Through the parabolic, and nicely done from Schumacher. As he now goes on to start the final lap. Treasure it, son. You never get this opportunity again. The banter bus is really true in parts, as Shane would like to say. Brakes for the chicane that will be removed for the 2017 season. And a hairpin added into here as we get an overtake. I saw in the background, it's Huge Bob and Maj Dope. Some action finally into this Italian Grand Prix. Maj Dope hitting the back of Huge Bob. This is going to be a great battle to the end. Maj not really troubling into this chicane. No. And a bit brutal. It's a bit closer to Gutierrez. But the main man is Schumacher. Is brutal. Can he do anything about Gutierrez? I don't think so. Looks a bit too far. Oh, it's a bit too far behind. But the main man is WF1 Schumacher, who rounds the final to take the Italian Grand Prix. Three Ferrari winners at Italy this weekend. Gutierrez takes second. Brutal finishes third. Magnussen finishes fourth. It's been a great result for Mercedes. Fifth is taken by Huge Bob. Maj takes sixth place. An old Manzi 31 for Lotus. Not at the pace this weekend, old Manzi, but I'm sure he'll come back fighting strong as we enter out of the European this season. As next will be Singapore at Marina Bay, a night race where I'm sure it'll be obviously a draining challenge for most of these drivers. As old Manzi rounds Ascari down the final straight, finishes a minute behind, but unlike Buzzkid, he did not finish. He finishes the race through Ascari. Well, I'm sure Manzi will have some great pace as we enter to the Asian part of the Formula One calendar as he crosses the line. What a fantastic as Brutal finishes second, there's a glitch. Fantastic. As Shane had a penalty. Now, if Brutal could have stayed a bit closer, he'd have won the race. Obviously, we've got a few. That's only provisional. As Maj Dope had 2 penalties. Well done, Maj. Anyway, Schumacher takes the win here at Italy in the Ferrari. Brit Brutal finishes second. Gutierrez third. Magnussen finishes fourth. Huge Bob fifth. Maj Dope finishes in sixth. So the two Lotuses rounding off the points in 6th and 7th with Old Manzi in 7th. Busker didn't finish the race after having a very good qualifying session, finished 5th on the prime tyres, but obviously couldn't make that work out. As we will that would definitely get changed around. Can we have a bit Britain in the party, please? I don't have anyone running this. Right. What are your expectations for the rest of the season? Do you feel like I'm not sure of the standings of GP3? I don't know where you are in the championship. Where are you in the championship? Where are you in the championship?
Think I went in second, like, but I know I'm going to miss at
As
least
far
two
as I'm aware,
races.
you're in second, mate.
Oh yeah, you are in
Well,
second.
like
Sorry,
second
Shane
or
said,
third
didn't
or
he?
something, but yeah.
Yeah, do you feel like you can
I'm not going to
chat?
challenge for
Well,
that. I don't think I can
you're
challenge
gonna miss
Schumacher.
races.
I can maybe challenge Gutierrez now and then on odd track, but generally I'm
Yeah.
just aiming to be in top four. But I know I'm going to miss two races, so at least two races because I go on holiday.
Would you say top three is the aim? Because obviously top three
Yeah.
race of champions.
That's
Yeah.
the aim, yeah.
Yeah, right. Well, congratulations on your third Brühl. Entertaining race to watch from me and no one else because I'm lonely.
You're a loner.
Yeah, I'm talking to a TV screen, but